Trillicop is here because the biostimulation word is growing and it's very important for us. What do we mean by this? Is that this is the real breakthrough, the innovation that is being built, brought to the market, brought to the farmers to improve the yields, to have better fruits, to have better productivities. And there are many, many things happening. The water quality is not improving around the world. Climate is more changing and all these things. So there's a lot of questions that are asked. And I think this kind of congress is fundamental for us to share what we know. And we've had a fantastic discussion this morning by our Thomas Fleming about the biostimulant effects of our products, the root mass effect and these kind of things, and also the gene expression that we can generate through the use of biostimulants within the plant. So all these elements are fundamental to share. We share to the market, but also we get information and we can connect with new companies, other companies, etc. So it's very important for us to be present, and we've been in the last three editions since the very beginning in 2011. Now we hope that the law will help us, because the new law of biostimulants will be a major milestone for Europe, clearly, but for the rest of the world. We need to have a legislation that enables small to medium companies to invest and to take any compound, any raw material, and work, have ideas. Creativity is all around, and we need to let these companies be able to grow, to develop, to innovate, and to propose new products, and this is fundamental. And today I am worried about this innovation capacity, because if it becomes too expensive to register a product, all the small companies will disappear, and that will be bad. And at the same time, if we lose one major concept that was at the beginning of the law, which is the dual use concept, or what they say today, parallel labeling, which is actually having one product, let's say nitrogen, for example, or copper is a typical example of dual use. Copper is at the same time a pesticide and a nutritional product, the way you use it. Okay, so this dual use is fundamental. You need to keep this as a possibility. If you decide suddenly that no, we cannot have dual use, then we're lost, because once it registers as a pesticide, it's gone. So we need to be very careful. Seaweed is directly in the line. Seaweed are registered as a pesticide. Will we be able to keep the seaweed as a biostimulant? I hope, I pray, but it's fundamental.